More on all this, we want to welcome a member of the Foreign Affairs Committee in the House, Florida Congresswoman Maria Alvarez-Salazar. It's great to have you on this morning, Congresswoman. You heard the secretary there. Take us through. You're from the state of Florida. They're going to be coming right to your state.
And thank you for the opportunity. And I agree with him that we do not pay enough attention to the hemisphere. I'm the chairman of the subcommittee on the Americas within House Foreign Affairs Committee. And he was saying that it's not our problem. It is our problem, but we need to engage the rest of our neighbors. Where is the rest of Latin American countries? Where are the Canadians? Where are the French? The Canadians did not want to touch the problem. It's been going on for 4 years. And when you said barbecue, barbecue, according to my own humble and personal opinion, should be barbecued himself.
Right.
Because this guy and the G9, they think that they are statesmen. They're just a bunch of criminals who have taken over the capital. And 90% of the Haitian capital is in the hands of the gangs. And you know they're using rape and sexual violence to control women and children. Mm-hmm. That's despicable.
Yeah.
So what I think that we need to do, the United States of America, we need to bring the CARICOM, which are the rest of the Caribbean islands that we have trade with, and we should put together a coalition and have a very solid presence, not necessarily our soldiers, but the influence of the United States. And like I said, the Dominicans and the Jamaicans and the Canadians. The Canadians have to be there, and the French. My chairman, Mr. McCall, the chairman of the House Foreign Affairs Committee, we have $300 million that have been requested by the State Department. I believe that we should be giving that money, but with guardrails. We need to know where is the money going to, how is it going to be spent, what's the exit plan. And I'm sure that you know that this money is to help the people from Kenya. Because Kenya, the country of Kenya, decided to send a troop, 1,000 soldiers from Kenya, not from this hemisphere, from the African continent, and we have to pay for it. Mm. Well, okay, $300 million, but just like we're doing with Ukraine, where is that money going to? How are we going to spend it? Transparency and an exit plan. So it's our problem. And Florida, and my governor is doing a fantastic job. We are a border state. I think Guantanamo is a very good idea.
So we understand that Governor DeSantis has deployed more than 250 additional officers, more than a dozen air and sea craft to protect Florida. He's doing what he can to protect the state from those migrants that now might be coming in. What do you think of his response so far?
I think he is doing the best he can, but let's look at reality. If you have thousands of people on rafts in the middle of the ocean, and I know that very well because, you know, I'm Cuban-American representing the Cuban exile community. We've had a couple of those incidents. The governor is we're humane. We're the United States. You have to do something with those people. And the best solution would be to move them to Guantanamo until the country stabilizes. We get rid of barbecue, which is the first thing we need to do. Send someone to get rid of him. And then stabilize the country and then send those migrants back when there is safety for them.
Okay, so Congresswoman, I just want to throw up the map for everyone at home one more time, because I don't think, you know, look, we've got one of our colleagues, Allison Maloney, who's one of the hosts here at Newsmax, she's got a cruise with her husband, and guess where they were spending 2 days? Port-au-Prince, Haiti. Obviously, Royal Caribbean has rescheduled. They're going to go somewhere else. But this is why the problems in Haiti are why. See the green part of the map there? That's all the Dominican Republic. Mm-hmm. And that's why they say resorts in the DR can be really dangerous because the border is super poor. So you think our border is bad. There's no wall. Some of it's mountainous, so it's challenging terrain. But the people of Haiti, how does the DR play a role here? Because that's a large country that's right there on the border with Haiti.
Mm-hmm. That's a very good question. And the Dominican Republic is the country in the hemisphere which has the biggest problem. Because like you said, they have a division. There are no barriers. And these are two completely different countries colonized by two completely different powers. Dominican Republic in the hands of the Spaniards, Haiti in the hands of the French.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying. Where are the French? They used to be a French colony. They have a moral duty, just like we have moral duties in some of the islands, some of the colonies that we acquired or that we had at the beginning of our history. So Dominican Republic, I have received a couple of calls from the Dominican ambassador in D.C. They are very worried, and that's why we, the United States, we need to say we're going to help you.
Yes.
But with guardrails, knowing where the money is going to. Because, you know, we are in a new era. Look at what's happening in Ukraine, that we know that we got to stop Vladimir Putin, that we cannot send the signal to Vladimir Putin that the United States is absent, sleeping at the wheel.
Right.
But
right.
But at the same time, we need to know where the money is going to. Guardrails. We're not in the era of spending money or just giving it away for corruption. Mm-hmm. Same issue with Haiti. Look, the Clinton administration in 2010, when I was a journalist, and I'm sure everyone remembers, in 2010. The Clinton administration told the world after there was this massive, devastating earthquake in Haiti to give them the millions and millions of dollars to refurbish and to reconstruct that island after it was decimated.
And where did all that money go? Where did all that money go?
Ask the Haitian.
You know, exactly.
Ask the
Haitian.
Exactly.
Yeah. Congresswoman, we've got to leave it there.
Yeah, very dark chapter in the Haitian history, and we are paying the consequences now.
Yeah, that's a great point. They were recovering from, of course, the earthquake in 2010. And just you think about the DR and those, if you've got, it's spring break, it's March. Mm-hmm. If you've got a trip planned, I would look and check on travel advisories. It's a very scary situation on that island. Congresswoman, appreciate you being with us and breaking all that down. Thank you.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you.